Welcome to my channel. Today is another hair update, and yes, I am 15 weeks post. I'm gonna be doing a relaxer in less than a week. I am approaching my 16 week stretch, and you know, so far so good. As I mentioned in my last video, you know, it's going really well. I've been using the S-Curl No Drip, and that is amazing. Like, that thing just makes me feel like I can stretch forever. But no, I really want to do a relaxer. So this video is just a quick update, and also a couple of tips as far as if you're going on a stretch yourself. Because for me, doing this 16 week stretch, it worked out really well. Because along the way, you have to train yourself and learn new things and try to adapt to certain things because of the hair's transition, but it was a pretty good experience for 4 months, and that's pretty much what I did this marker here. I'm gonna give you guys a couple of tips, things that can help you on the way if you are venturing into doing a hair stretch or even transitioning, because as far as the hair stretch goes, it's all about gaining new growth in your hair, and all that applies the same as if someone is transitioning from relaxed to natural hair. And I respect all of my natural girls out there. Yes, so moving on. So tip number one, and what I was just mentioning, you know, you gradually stretch into your relaxer. You know, you have a certain amount of time that you're going to stretch in between your relaxes, whether it's going to be 6 to 8 weeks, 12 to 16 weeks, 4 to 5, 6 to 7 months, however you go. You have some time in between there as far as gaining new growth. When you do go into your relaxer, you know, you're not going to be overlapping and over-processing the hair with any chemicals. Pretty much what stretching is, it's like gaining a lot of time in between your relaxers, allowing your hair to rest and, you know, catch itself and to get some new growth, enough, a substantial amount of growth that, you know, you can relax where, you know, you're not going to be interfering with the already relaxed hair. Another thing as far as stretching your hair, you need to work in sections, because when the hair starts growing out, you're getting all the new growth, it's gonna start thickening up there, and it's not gonna be as easy to take a comb and glide it front to back and just get everything going. No, you're gonna have to section that hair and comb out each section, taking your time, because it's not gonna happen. It's not gonna have any comb gliding front to back. It's not gonna happen. Like, I remember when I was very reckless with my hair, as soon as I can glide a comb front to back, I'm getting a relaxer. That's it. I'm not playing. I'm getting a relaxer. That was the really messed up thing that I didn't know, and I was really messing up my hair and doing all this damage and stuff. But yeah, as far as being on a stretch and you start gaining new growth and it starts thickening up, you're gonna have to section your hair. My advice would be, you know, part down the middle. And you know, how many you want to put, however amount or little you want to put in there, but once you section that hair to detangle it, all well and good. So yeah, that as far as detangling the hair, another tip, you won't be able to just like, no, that's not how it goes. You start from the bottom, you work your way up, and that's gonna loosen up whatever down here, so by the time you get up to your scalp, it's easy to just comb everything down because the ends are already free of any tangles. Now, when I was going through my stretch, you kind of develop a little trick that helped me to detangle my hair a little, but I only did this after I did a wash. And, you know, I put my products in, you know, I kind of combed down on the root of my hair with a paddle brush, you know, just to loosen up the hair a little. I didn't brush it all the way through. I just kind of like lightly, nice little thing there. So by the time I comb from the bottom up, I just had like a little area here that needed to be loosening up, and it was pretty good. It worked for me. It's not my advice for you to do, because you can damage the hair if you're doing certain things and, you know, not taking your time or anything. But a little trick that I had that really worked for me, I'm not telling you to do it or whatever, but detangling your hair is another thing you have to really take your time with as far as going through a stretch. Because of all the new growth, you have to invest that time to sit down, section your hair, detangle it. And the right way to detangle your hair is start from the bottom and you work your way up. Now another tip that's really, really essential as far as going through a stretch, moisture. Moisture, moisture, moisture. You have to moisturize your hair. As far as the new growth and the relaxed hair, I mentioned the line of demarcation. That's where the relaxed hair and the new growth meet. That is prone for breakage. It's a fragile area, and as far as getting new growth in your hair and you're dealing with these two textures, pay attention to that line of demarcation. Always make sure that your hair is moisturized, it's saturated. It's always good to use a water-based conditioner, a moisturizing conditioner. Put that into your hair and you saturate your hair. Make sure that, you know, you do it from root to tip and you do this as often as possible. By moisturizing the hair, this increases the elasticity in your hair. So, you know, that's gonna help to further strengthen it up. Because you don't want to leave that hair brittle and dry hanging there, because if something is dry, it is going to break. Make sure that you moisturize your hair. And this goes for transitioning also, because this process, as far as stretching the hair and getting new growth, it applies the same if someone is transitioning from relaxed to natural. So keep in mind, always moisturize. Another tip, washing your hair, cleansing your hair. Maybe you do this on a weekly basis. I won't recommend to be washing your hair daily unless there's some type of major epidemic going on with your hair. But as far as stretching your hair, you know, you don't want to be putting too much harsh shampoos and stuff in your hair on a regular basis, because you know shampoo does strip the hair of a lot of its essential oils. Look for a shampoo like sulfate free. That's pretty good. Me personally, I love to do a lot of deep conditioning. I only shampoo once a month, and I deep condition for the remaining weeks within the month, because I don't want to have to be using shampoo, cleansing, washing my hair, washing out all the essential oils from my hair. So as far as cleansing your hair, you know, you build up a routine as far as how you're going to wash your hair, what day you're going to wash your hair, because you have to have this planned out also. You just don't want to wash your hair on any given day. If you know you're going to wash your hair every Saturday, you stick to washing your hair every Saturday. Have a fixed date as far as when you're gonna be washing your hair. And again, try to look for a sulfate-free shampoo, something that's gonna be gentle on the hair that will still cleanse the hair from any type of buildup. So now drying your hair, another tip. I will not recommend using a harsh towel on your hair. Something soft that will be gentle on the hair, because you want to treat this hair very, very delicately. In a state where you don't want to be putting too much hard materials on it, because you know these things can cause breakage, it can cause split ends. So you want to look for something really nice and soft that you can just wrap your hair, let it absorb all of the water. But don't go in and start rubbing and shuffling your hair around. Number one, that's going to cause a lot of knots. You're gonna get breakage, you're gonna get split ends, you're shuffling your hair back and forth with a towel like that. I only see guys do that pretty much. You know, they can pretty much do that. Yeah, but you don't wanna go rubbing your hair back and forth. The best thing to do is either you get some type of nice, probably like a microfiber towel, and you wrap your hair with that and let it gradually absorb the water, and or even better yet, you air dry your hair. And you know, this is gonna cut down from you having to put extra heat in your hair. So either way, always be gentle, even with drying your hair. Another tip I'm gonna mention again, and it's that you're gonna constantly be hearing this, the line of demarcation where the relaxed hair and the new growth meets. That is a very fragile, sensitive area, and you have to really be careful and very gentle with this hair. I mean, if you know you want to stretch, you're gonna definitely have line of demarcation. And if you don't want to develop any type of breakage, I mentioned it earlier, you have to be doing a lot of moisture. You're gonna have to be gentle with your hair, and that goes in for everything as far as combing your hair, washing your hair, drying your hair. All of these things has a part to play as far as protecting that line of demarcation. So you want to try to avoid from getting the hair, from roughing the hair in any type of way, because again, that's a very fragile area and it's prone to breakage. But the main thing is always, you know, just be gentle with the hair. Baby the hair as much as you can. Another tip, low manipulation, and this falls in the category of styles. Now, when you are on this stretch, now remember your hair is growing out, you're dealing with two textures, and some of the styles that you could have done when your hair was fully relaxed without the new growth may not be able to be achieved with the new growth. In my last update video, I showed you guys where I did my sleek bun, and in order for me to achieve that, I have to make a side part. That really helped as far as controlling the hair, and you know, two textures are just like boom, in your face right there. So by doing a side part, it helped me a lot. I won't even advise doing like sew-ins and stuff, because you know, putting that extra weight on the hair, I can really weigh the hair down, and that can further break the hair also. How do you do braid outs, a lot of, you know, probably pin-up styles, you wear wigs, things just to help your stretch along, and as far as, you know, you wanting to wear styles and certain things. I did my little buns and I tried to maintain it for at least a day or two, so I know that was pretty much downtime on my hair and I didn't have to go and start moving around in there to irritate my growth. The less you can put your hands in your hair, the better. You know, that will give the hair a chance to just sit there, rest, take its time and do its thing, and, you know, not get, you know, roughed up in any way. Last but not least, have patience. Sometimes, you know, you're looking for fast results, but everything takes time, and once you dedicate your time and you know you do the right things that you have to do as far as maintaining your hair, maintaining the growth, and you know, just keeping your hair at a standard, you will see the results, you know, even faster than you think. I started on my journey, my hair, well, it was really, really short, and I played around with the style and I enjoyed the hair. By me doing all the small little things that I know was right for my hair, I didn't even know when it just grew out, but I enjoyed the hair. Be patient, just know that you have to protect your ends, moisturize, do your protein treatments, seal your hair, and just take your time and you'll get the results that you need. So I am so glad that you guys stuck around with me for the stretch that I did, and we are relaxing this hair in less than a week. I'm really excited. I just can't wait to get it done. I'm so happy that you guys are supporting my channel, my new subscribers, all my other subscribers. So glad you guys are part of my little family here, and I just love all your comments. I just love all your feedback. I'm so glad you guys are supporting me, and likewise, I would love to support you guys as well. So thanks so much for watching, and come back for my relaxer video. Now, we don't want to miss that. So you guys take care, and I'll see you again. Bye.